GearNetwork.com.
The following is a presentation of the Gear Radio Network.
What's up, rockers? This is the rock star Robbie Vegas, professional wrestler and host of the All Bets Are Off podcast. But right now, you're listening to the Fantasy Football Bros podcast. So take it away, Chaz.
Here we go, here we go. Hey, everything on three. Number three. Win on one. Oh, win on three. One, two, three. Win.
You are now listening to the Fantasy Football Bros Podcast.
Welcome back to the Fantasy Football Bros Podcast. It's your boy, Chaz, and I am joined by the man, the myth, the legend, Jay Coleman. Jay, what's up, dog?
What's up?
And I am also joined by the no-nickname, no-nonsense, Adam Van Houten. Adam, what is up?
Oh, what's going on, guys?
And we have a special guest, ladies and gentlemen, the number two overall pick in the draft, country music superstar Eric Van Houten. What's going on, dude?
What's up?
So how did you end up watching the wrestling match that you were involved in?
What?
You didn't fill him in on everything?
He was super high.
He was super high.
I was probably baked.
I just told him what pick he had.
Yeah. Well, you got a pick because we did a Royal Rumble. And this is good. I get to fill
this
in.
Okay, I like this.
So we did a Royal Rumble with all of us.
Chaz created all of us on WWE 2K, what is it, 22 or 23?
The newest one, 22. So I created all of us, 20-man Rumble. There's eight other characters, but they're all out. So we're at the end, and it's all of us, and we're wrestling, and the winner's going to get first overall pick.
Sure.
Well, all of a sudden, Jay throws Adam out and just standing in the ring for 25 minutes alone because you were too busy to come out to the ring. So then you two had to have a ladder match to determine
that's fair
who was the number one pick. And that you did all the work, and then Jay threw you off the ladder and won.
Oh, that's absolute garbage. Garbage. If I was here,
you got all the notches down on the briefcase. And
no.
Then just...
Hey, Jay, I had to wrestle two matches.
Jay came over and unclipped it.
Was my character bleeding at least? Did he look good?
Well, I think it looked good.
He looked good. He looked like country music superstar. Look at me. That's for sure.
So, if you would you have rather had first pick? And if you did, would you would have went JT like Jay did?
I don't know. I'm happy with Cup.
Yeah,
I'm happy with Cup Dog.
I mean, he's like. Look, we had between the four of us, we had four of the top five picks.
I probably would have taken Cup first overall anyway.
I'm the one that fucked up.
No, I think Adam's the one that fucked up.
I am the one that fucked up by taking Eckler instead of Jefferson, like I was thinking.
Yikes!
And Jay took JT, but I mean he's been half and half.
Yeah, but JT will turn it on. The only problem is Matt Ryan can't do shit. So
well, that's so ugly. I can't believe how they're looking right now.
Well, this is gonna sound crazy. But you just can't get rid of Carson Wentz when he's buzzing for the Colts.
Right? I mean,
he had a hell of a season. Granted, they didn't make the playoffs on a last-minute play or whatever it was last year. But you can't get rid of Carson Wentz when they were – I mean, that was a tandem that got Taylor the first overall pick this season.
Right.
Why would you not keep that?
And then they were like only – I think it was a Jacksonville loss away from making the playoffs.
Yes.
And I just saw a stat that they have not won in Jacksonville since 2014.
Which makes perfect sense.
I wish I would have known that before I started Matt Ryan this week.
Jay started Matt Ryan. Yep. Nice little.
Yep.
Did you get even 5 points?
You can't sleep.
It was like
four. You can't sleep.
But
on
it wouldn't have mattered because I had Tom Brady and he didn't do anything either. So
you can't sleep on the Jags when there's stat lines out there that prove that the Jags will get one or two dubs every season.
Like when they beat the fucking Bills last year.
It's against certain teams. And they just. I'm not a Lawrence guy.
That was a
I think
freak
he looks a
accident,
little,
though.
Looks like he should go back to California and surf. But
I mean, I don't think he's like throw him out of the league like Zach Wilson yet. But like, I mean, he's not. He didn't come in and rock the world like everybody thought he was.
Speaking of Zach Wilson, if the Jets don't stick with Big Dog Joe for the rest of the season, I will blow a gasket.
There's no way
they stick with Joe Flacco.
I mean, why not? The dude's a monster.
Because you just drafted Wilson in the second overall pick.
Let
last
him learn
year.
A thing or two.
This
you're talking about throwing him out of the league. Let him learn a thing or two.
I mean, but that's just not how it goes. You know, like it's just it's. unless they would have made that call already, but he was the starter. And like they always say that you shouldn't lose your job for an injury, right? So it's just
100% kind of, you should when Big Joe comes in and wins a game against the Browns big on a Flacco. Comeback.
Big comeback, though.
I mean,
yeah, huge. Massive comeback. Puts huge. The Browns to shame.
Well, the Browns are the always
the better quarterback.
Flacco is 100% a better quarterback.
That's the case, man. Zach Wilson's terrible.
He is terrible.
I don't like Zach Wilson.
What do you mean?
At all.
Does Joe Flacco not have a Super Bowl in his belt?
He does. He does. But
what are we chirping him for? He's a Hall of Fame quarterback.
He hasn't been necessarily good for like 6-7 years, though. Honestly,
he's playing on the Jets, and they're not good anyway.
100%. And he was with the Ravens, and they were automatically going with Lamar, no doubt.
But he wasn't good with the Eagles. He wasn't good with the Broncos, and Lamar took him his rookie year. So it's just like and Flacco was already on his way down by that point. I was
still
a big Flacco
career.
Guy. He could very
he
well
could make a buzz back. We've seen it before.
It's interesting. I mean, it's the Jets. I mean,
let Big Joe play.
Hey, he turned Garrett Wilson into a thing, and me and Jay kind of shit talked Garrett Wilson at the beginning.
This dude's out of his mind.
What you guys got cooking over
he's
there?
He's trying to trade me. We're going back and forth.
Eric's in second to last place and needs a quarterback.
Watch the comeback.
I'm trying to give him.
I'm
trying to trade him Matt Stafford.
But you have a bunch of garbage quarterbacks, Adam.
They're trying to give me Matt Stafford.
They're not garbage. Matt Stafford's not bad.
Matt Stafford, Logan Thomas for Dawson Knox and Elijah Moore.
I don't see a problem with that.
Dawson's my dude. I just can't get rid of him.
Now, as someone on the outside,
you can trade me Logan Thomas. I need a tight end.
I'll trade you Logan Thomas.
I think we'll make a
three-way
trade right here.
Now, I think it's a fair trade, but that's up to you guys. I wanted to offer a Jay right on the air that he's going to say no to, but you never know. I might get him.
Let's hear it.
Here's a trade offer, Jay, straight up, and he would have never thought this would be true. My starting quarterback for your starting quarterback, Carson Wentz for Tom Brady. Let's go. Carson Wentz is the number 3 overall quarterback right now.
I probably should do it.
Jay just picked up Jared Goff, though, who's having a pretty decent 2 games here.
It's out there, so it's up to you. Like, I'm rolling with Carson Wentz, but if I could get Brady, in my mind, it's like, I think he's going to turn it around.
But I don't know if you saw this, but
Brady's
on Jay's bench right now.
Yeah, well, I mean, that's...
Yeah, because he sucks right now, and all of his wide receivers are dead.
That is true.
Is it true Brady's going through a divorce?
That's rumored out there that she left him, and that's sad.
Yeah, she supposedly moved out.
Because he went back to
allegedly.
Because he went back to football.
Because he went back to football, and the Bahamas wasn't enough to keep her around.
You just can't leave the game when you're a guy like Tom Brady.
I agree. I fully agree. I support it.
Respectfully, should have left after he won the Super Bowl, but respectfully, the dude's just a dog. Period. We can all respect the hell out of that.
Well, to be fair, Eric, he won the Super Bowl and came back the next year and had the second greatest season of his whole career.
Insane.
So, and then he's coming into
what,
this
44?
Year.
And didn't win MVP. Whatever age he is.
Yeah. And then he comes back into this year, adds Julio Jones, and like you think he's going to tear it up, but literally all his receivers are dead.
Literally.
But the thing is, you see what happens in a game like last week with the Saints. It's literally a 3-3 game the entire time, the most boring NFL game of week 2.
Yes.
And then you tick him off once and it's 20-3 in a matter of minutes. Like that's what he does.
Yeah. And he's been garbage this year, and so is Aaron Rodgers. So it's just like sometimes
a lot of players
also,
have been garbage
can we
so far.
Agree on the fact that the first 2 or 3 weeks of every NFL season over the last decade have been completely asinine, and you just don't know what's going to happen until like week 4.
The last 2 years have been even worse because like they have less preseason.
Yeah,
and I think
agree.
The players have looked like shit the first couple of weeks with the last preseason games.
I think that's true. I think they're rusty.
I can agree with that.
They're super rusty when they come back.
But let's also discuss Aaron Rodgers and the fact that he is an absolute machine. And the fact that he started off trash the first couple games of last year, and then they literally won 13 in a row.
He went 0-2 last year and then came back and won.
Well, that's what I mean. He's my starting quarterback, but like he is not doing well right now. So he had two.
Who cares? He's got to learn the system with the new cats. Like, period.
Hey,
he doesn't have Devontae. You got to figure it out. And
Chaz,
he's a professional quarterback.
Aaron Rodgers going to win the MVP?
Probably. I mean, he's probably going to win it somehow.
If we're being honest, gambling talk, he was plus 2,500 last year to win MVP after the 0-2 start, and I definitely put $250 on it, and I hit it. So
nice.
Be smart. Aaron Rodgers.
Well, yeah, the smart bet to win MVP bet-wise is not Josh Allen. It's just you got to, you know, a smart bet to win MVP beginning of the season.
Jameis Winston.
You know who else he could
MVP
have been?
MVP candidate.
What about Amon-Ra St. Brown? That guy is tearing it up right now. That his Who knows what his odds were at the beginning of
it's
the
season. It's a quarterback, though. It's always going to be a quarterback.
It's always a quarterback.
And Jameis Winston might be set to have
comeback player of the year
right now.
So I've got a question for you guys. What do these players have in common? Ready?
Oh, here we go.
Here we go. Keenan Allen, Gabe Davis, Julio Jones, Chris Godwin. What do these players have?
They're all hurt with an ankle injury.
They were all out, and they're all my receivers. So, if you guys didn't realize in this league, my starting two receivers last week were Alan Lazard snuck in, and even though he's injured, yep. And I had to start that white dude from the Titans that fumbled the ball.
Poor fella.
So obviously I lost this week when I had that lineup. So like
I got lucky this week. If we want to talk about
what, go ahead. We're having the league. We can review.
I won by less than 3 points.
Oh, that's right. So what happened?
I'm pretty sure I had Adam Thielen on Monday night, who got me 9 points.
Stellar, right, Jay?
Yeah,
and Adam's trying to trade me him right now, which is hysterical.
Jay's ears perked up.
Hey,
Adam Thielen trade?
What? I mean, I'm down to trade him, but I have a
trade on the board.
You have a trade
so
on the board.
You're taking it or you're not?
Say it out loud.
Adam Thielen's dead too.
I don't know.
Matt Stafford, Logan Thomas for Njoku and Elijah Moore.
Hey, Jay.
Yes or no?
How do you feel about Zeke?
He's garbage.
Logan Thomas for Zeke Elliott.
Ooh.
Wow. This dude's just going to backhand me right in front of my face, and he's my brother.
Welcome to the podcast. Wow. Welcome to the Better Deal.
Welcome to the Better Deal. That's a good name for a podcast. The Better Deal. You guys got Jay's wheel spinning.
I got Jay thinking now.
Jay used to
just hit accept on mine, and we could be friends.
Well, if I can get Zeke, then we'll be friends, because I'll still trade you Stafford.
Zeke is not going to do anything without Dak.
That's fine. I don't need Zeke. He's a flex guy.
Although
for me.
He might. Cooper Rush could also have an MVP.
I mean, CeeDee Lamb had 11 targets with Cooper Rush. The volume's still there.
Underrated.
I don't know if he's underrated. I think he's rated exactly where
he needs to be.
I got you.
I'm all about the backup quarterbacks. 100%.
Depending on who it is.
On some of these teams, I'm all about the backup.
Like, you want to start them in fantasy? 100%. Really?
Not starting. Well, I mean, if they're starting on the team, yeah.
Well, yes, of course. That's what I mean. Like, you would run out and start them.
I'd throw Cooper Rush out there. Here's a good question. Who do the Cowboys play next week?
I don't know. We'll look at your roster, Jay. You have Zeke.
They play the Giants.
Oh, my God.
Yeah,
I'm looking
start
at it right
Cooper
now.
Rush.
You mean the 2-0?
Right now.
You mean the
2-0?
The
2-0 New York
Giants.
Football Giants?
I will say, I do think
ran
the,
by
the Giants
Brian
will win.
Dable himself?
The Giants will win against the Cowboys, but
actually,
start Cooper.
Actually, add
start
on
Cooper.
To that. The 2-0 Giants with the best running back in fantasy football on their roster.
I will say, Shaq's having
Who is it, Chaz?
That'd be my baby boy, Saquon Barkley.
hold on 1 second. This is a quick timeout for our sponsor.
Oh, yeah. Actually, we forgot to take our sponsor break, but we'll take that a little bit later. It doesn't have to be in the middle of the show. Guys, I got two guys on the trading block for your running back needing people. Darrell Henderson Jr. and Cordarrelle Patterson on the trading block.
Oh,
I would like a receiver or maybe a quarterback, but none of your trash quarterbacks, Adams. But I would like a receiver.
He acts like he's got the best quarterbacks in the league.
No, but I just don't want fucking Russell Wilson.
I didn't offer you Russell Wilson.
No one wants Russell Wilson.
And like... I wouldn't trade Cordarrelle Patterson for Matt Stafford.
I wasn't going to offer you.
Are you going to accept my trade?
First of all, my offer for Jay is Zeke for Logan Thomas.
You can't go one for one on that, Jay. I will stare you blank in the eyes and tell you.
To me, I don't think that's
you
a
can't
trade.
Do that. You got to get a little more out of him.
Yeah,
you
I
could
don't
do
think
like
that's a great
you know.
Trade.
It's just an offer.
Who else you got floating around there, Adam?
You're pulling the Chaz right now.
All right, okay. Let me. All right, hold on. Let's do this. Chaz, who's on your trade block?
Cordarrelle Patterson and Darrell Henderson Jr.
Jay, who's on your trade block?
Everyone.
His whole team.
His whole team, because he's in last place.
Since I had my worst start ever in my decade plus.
My trade block is Adam Thielen, Devin Duvernay, Josh Jacobs,
nobody wants
and
Devin
Matt Stafford.
Devin
Duvernay has 2 touchdowns in 2 games, and one of them is a kickoff return for a touchdown. Still 6 points.
How are you going to do our guy?
He has more.
Like that?
He has more. Fantasy points than a lot of star players.
Yeah, because he had big week one. You're right. He did have a big week.
Semi-decent week two. He had 42 yards and a couple and what, 3-4 catches and the touchdown. You don't get the return yards, but you get the touchdown. That's that was 12
brother,
or 13 points.
I feel slightly disrespected that you won't just accept this trade. Honestly, it's a little offensive.
You're going to disrespect country music superstar Van Houten?
maybe a little.
Put him on the spot.
I'm looking at it.
Well, that trade, I think the one that you guys are talking about over there is fair. I don't think the trade with for Zeke
Elijah Moore and David Njoku.
Yeah, you're getting a good wide receiver three, wide receiver four that could be a star with Joe Flacco.
Just yeah, if Joey Bag of Donuts stays in the game,
Joey Bag of Donuts is the man.
And if not, though, to be fair, Elijah Moore was fantastic last year with Big Dick Zach. So it is what it is.
He was when he came back.
Gio's making amazing points to this game.
He was. I was big on Elijah Moore this year. And me and Jay were down on Garrett Wilson, so we're eating a little bit of crow right now on that one because he killed it last week. So we're looking silly on that take.
Yeah, it happens.
But Drake London's even better, and we called that. And Jameson Williams is going to be better. Who's got him? Oh, me and my IR. Smart drafting.
Eric, if you instead of Njoku, give me Hayden Hurst, I'll do it right now.
Ooh. So say the terms now.
So it would be Matt Stafford and Logan Thomas for Elijah Moore and Hayden Hurst.
The wheels are spinning over here. I'm watching.
I mean, yeah, let's do it.
All right.
Happening right now.
There it is, live on the Fantasy Football Bros podcast.
I mean, I'm cool with it. I'm not one to reject trades if you know the people are doing smart. So
well, my thing, I need that QB one. I mean, I have QB one in Jameis Winston because he's an absolute dog.
So then, why make the trade then?
That's got like 47.
Because he doesn't have that much faith in
fractured vertebrae.
I do. I just worry about his health.
Yeah, I mean, you should
respectfully.
Sorry, Jay. You're going to have to try and get Logan Thomas from country music superstar Eric Van Houten.
It's okay. I'll have three tight ends at that point. We can make a move. And I'll be far more giving than my brother.
Hey, all I wanted was Hayden Hurst.
That's what all the
chicks everything
say
else
too.
Was fine.
Well, Jay, we got Carson Wentz staring at you in the face over this way for Tom Brady. Yeah. So,
all right.
It's always an option.
Trade has been accepted.
Ooh, so it has went through, ladies. You heard on the episode, was it 17 of the Fantasy Football Bros podcast?
So.
The first live trade.
Live
on
trade.
Air.
Bingo.
Was not expecting that.
And boom. Yeah, it's me. That's why I'm here. I'm here for the goodness of the people.
Country music superstar Eric Van Houten is for the people, y'all.
For the people.
That's going to be his next album name. Fourth.
Oh, trade will process 9/24. I think our commissioner has to push it through.
Yeah, I'll change that. I didn't even realize.
That's fine.
I wonder who the commissioner.
Why did it do that? Did ours trade go right through?
I think you had to push it through.
No, I had to change it because it was. You're right. I think I have to push it through. I might have gotten the update. Let's even see because me and Jay tried to trade and then it hit that. Is it still doing the review like
here,
vote?
We'll throw a hot take out.
Oh no, here we go. I approved it.
I'll throw a hot take out there. You guys were chatting up Trey Lance earlier.
Oh, boy.
No, it's correction. Chaz chats up Trey Lance.
Yeah. I did not chat.
And he convinced Adam, and Adam was like three quarters of the way on Trey Lance.
All right, the trade went
I was,
through, by the way. Yeah.
And then I was, it, as a backup,
there was only one
was
person
okay
on this podcast that was anti-Trey Lance.
So you think
I'm still anti-Trey Lance.
The reason he's out for the year is because he sucks, not because he took a weird hit.
He sucks, and anyway. He's made of glass.
Eric, let's hear the hot take.
Hot take, it should have been Jimmy G from the rip. Period.
That's not really that hot of a take, to be honest.
Garoppolo is the
because
man.
I agree.
Not only is he the best looking dude in football, we can all agree on that. But Jimmy G can
are you
Jimmy
comparing
G
him
brought,
to you?
He beat Aaron Rodgers in the playoffs last year.
He always does.
Well, that's everybody beats Aaron Rodgers in the playoffs except one year.
Right.
You're so, pissing me off.
2000 what? 10 when he won
10 or 11, yeah. I'm Mr. I'm not you know I'm not high on Aaron Rodgers well playoff Aaron Rodgers
you're not.
That's where I go. I mean obviously he's a great quarterback.
Absolutely disgusting.
I think the thing with Trey Lance is you've had Jimmy for 3 years. You've made it to a Super Bowl, lost. You never got back. He's a super good game manager, and you just brought in some guy that could be electric. And you could teach an electric guy to be a game manager. You can teach Trey to do what Jimmy does. You can't teach Jimmy to do what Trey does. And I think that's why they made the change.
I just don't think Trey has it. I don't think he's him.
I don't think he's
he ain't
had,
him.
I don't think he's
Jimmy
had a
G is
chance.
Him.
You can't teach how not to get injured.
Well, that's true. I mean, look at who
he was
the,
on a run play.
But look at who the debate was between Trey Lance and Justin Fields. Are you going to say Justin Fields is that much better or Mac Jones is that much better?
Don't even get me started on Mac Jones.
I would have traded 3 first-round picks to not draft Mac Jones or Justin Fields.
I think Mac Jones is just good simply because of Bill Belichick.
But that's Jimmy Garoppolo. They're the same kind of quarterback.
Jimmy went into San Francisco and went to the Super Bowl.
Yes, he did. I'm not shitting on Jimmy. I'm just saying, like,
I think you're shitting on Jimmy.
No, I think they made the choice of, like, trying to be.
He's trying to
suck off Trey Lance.
Yes.
Who are some of the best quarterbacks in fantasy football right now? We're talking fantasy football.
Josh Allen.
Yes. Josh Allen,
number one.
All right.
Lamar Jackson, unfortunately. I hate to admit
Jalen Hurts, right?
Jalen Hurts.
And that's the mold of Trey Lance. Big arm running quarterbacks. And that's why I thought Trey Lance is not a top five fantasy quarterback right now.
Yeah,
he's out.
I could agree with that, but Jalen Hurts has a body.
Guys, can I point out that
Lamar Jackson has a body. Josh Allen has a body.
I don't think Lamar has a body. I think Lamar's small, and that's why he gets banged up. Trey Lance is...
I beat the entire New Orleans Saints team yesterday.
Oh, yeah.
This week, by the way. I had to point that out. I'm sorry.
Have you ever looked at...
For interrupting.
Fourth overall draft pick. What's his team name?
Winston's Crab Legs.
Have you ever looked at his team?
I haven't.
Take a look at it right now. I want you to see if you
Let me tell you right now. He started Michael Thomas, Mark Ingram.
He might have beat me week one, to be honest with you.
Chris Olave, Will Lutz, and the New Orleans defense.
He's got 6 or 7 Saints on his squad.
Yeah, he beat me week one by 6 points.
And he was probably...
And he has Alvin Kamara. He was obviously injured this week, so he has...
And the reason why he beat me is because I put Devontae Smith in, and he had 0 points.
Yeah, well, week one, Devontae had a goose egg. Weird.
Yeah.
Weird. Question, Adam. Nate, who am I? I was the number one quarterback in fantasy football this week.
Lamar Jackson.
Oh, goodness gracious. How's your call doing that he sucks and he's not going to be good at fantasy football this year?
I didn't say he wasn't going to be good. I think he sucks as a passer is I was referring to.
We are in fantasy.
Which, unfortunately, I am eating my fucking words because he has thrown for like 600 yards in 2 games.
Believe me,
I will fully admit
also, that
I was completely wrong.
Miami was a complete anomaly. Like, that was insane to watch.
He had all that shit in the first half, too.
That was insane to watch.
Now, if you think
Dude
about
ran
it.
Ran for 75 yards.
Right? And if you think about it. The Dolphins, everyone's talking about Tua. Tua had 430 and 6 touchdowns.
6 touchdowns.
3, and he still had 3 or 4 points less than Lamar Jackson. That's what the running game is. That's why Jalen Hurts is like the man right now in fantasy football.
Yeah.
And we actually all, I don't
it's,
know if Jason.
It's pretty scary, but the Eagles kind of look good again, and it's tough to deal with. But they have 2 Pro Bowl freaking cornerbacks in Bradbury and Slay. And then you have
And they just Jaylen. Brought in CJ.
They just brought in CJ. You got AJ Brown on the outside. Like, the Titans trading AJ Brown was the dumbest thing I've seen in a long time from a GM.
Yep.
Period. And it's proving points because the Titans are going to be dog water this year. Like, absolute dog shit.
You don't say.
Okay, but the Bills are also very powerful.
But they
like,
also
not even being biased, they are a powerful team. You know what I mean?
Well,
shut down Derrick Henry and Tannehill can't do it, but not many teams can shut down Derrick Henry.
And we got to be fair, you know, you have ties to both cities right now.
I do, but I will never, ever root for the Titans. No offense to Nashville or the Titans.
that a boy.
That's just not happening.
That a boy.
But as a football fan, as a football, like, in, you know, connoisseur, if you will, the Titans made a terrible call getting rid of that guy because on the outside with A.J. Brown, like, he is a weapon and a half.
And he's a monster.
If you can't necessarily beat down the middle with Henry, you at least had somebody on the outside that can match the Robert Woods. Or, you know, you look at last season, they had Julio Jones.
And, for like 3 games.
They had Julio Jones and they had A.J. Brown. And they had Robert Woods last season, right?
No.
Or, no, that was just this
season.
No,
they got him this year.
They got him this year.
But still, regardless, you had A.J. Brown. I mean, that is enough on an outside. Like, the dude could be double covered and still catch a 30-yard pass midfield.
They got rid of A.J. Brown and now teams are just playing.
Stacking the box.
Yep.
Period.
Because they know that they don't have shit for wide receivers now. So,
but I'll tell you what, with that draft pick that they got for him, Treylon Burks, I mean, that could be A.J. Brown in 3 years.
But he's got to develop.
Yes.
You can't just let a kid like that walk into a situation where he's the only dog.
Yep.
You know what I mean?
And AJ Brown was a second round pick. He didn't have as much like hoopla hype, behind him and hype. So like Treylon Burks was somebody like I wasn't too sure about, but like it's not nothing he did, but just seeing him on the field, that dude is big, that dude is fast, that dude is explosive. So I think he could be a good AJ Brown replacement. But he also has Ryan Tannehill, who's a very game manager, Mac quarterback, and Malik Willis is one of the worst quarterbacks I've ever seen in my life.
I'm very concerned why. I mean, the Titans GM just had to be high as hell paying Tannehill that much money.
Well, that's the thing is that comes from the coach and the coach of like, you know, he's such an old school. We're going to pound the ball. Like, that's cool in 1977, bro. Like this, you know, you don't. When's the last time a pound the rock team won the Super Bowl? Just off the top of your head. Yeah, pound the rock team won the Super Bowl.
Like, mean, even the Rams last year, like they had
passing
with Stafford. Like, yeah, I mean, you have Cam Akers, but they—I don't know if they ran the ball much again.
And
Super Bowl.
Brady won 47 of them, and Manning won a bunch, and Breeze, and like you might have to go to that Joe Flacco year.
I was going
to
say Baltimore, maybe.
And who
Joe
was the
Flacco?
Back in that era with the Ravens?
Well, that was Ray Rice.
Ray Rice. So you had Ray Rice pounding and ground, like ground and pounding it. But then you also had the absolute stout defense that the Ravens were back in the day.
And that's about a decade ago. And before that, it was still quarterback. So that like
game management
era's done.
Game management.
If you look at the best, okay, so the best three teams in the league right now, I would say are the Bills, the Chiefs, and the Eagles. Does any of them have a
totally
all-star
agree.
Running back? No.
Yeah. Really. The Eagles have Miles Sanders.
He's doing well, and Hilaire's doing well, but
he
said not,
elite running back.
They're not setting the world
that was
on
the joke.
Fire. You know, it's like it's a new generation. And I think teams like the Titans and like the fucking Patriots, sure, they're going to win a game. They're going to surprise you and beat somebody because of clock control and stuff like that. Good for you guys. You're never going to win a Super Bowl.
I want to tie our league back into this, and I want to know what Jay was feeling when he saw Jaylen Waddle get 40 points. And everything that's coming after that 40 points.
Who has Waddle?
Was he on your bench?
I have him, and I also had to play against him in the other league. So,
so you have him in our league?
Yes. He does. Yeah. Yes. But talking fantasy football.
Was he on the bench? Or?
No, he was in his lineup.
But
I'm just saying.
I think the question is, it was
a 1 o'clock game. He's seeing 40 points from Waddle, going, yes,
I'm gonna win easily.
Well, I knew I won because like I didn't have Pittman and. I started Matt Ryan.
I mean, Brady.
I just want to know what was going through Jay's head on this one.
I thought I might have a chance finally this week, but, you know.
Well, I had to start the white dude from Titans, so. Jay's looking up the squad.
No.
I'm looking at the matchup. I'm looking at the matchup from last week, and I just wanted, you know.
I mean, we're all in multiple fantasy leagues.
Sure.
We're chit-chatting about other leagues and stuff, and I'm absolutely sick about it.
Well, you always get that. I'm in five paid leagues this year, and literally every league I either had Waddle or was against Waddle or against Josh Allen or like it gets there.
So in our main league, I was against Waddle this week, and he also had Cup, Mark Andrews, and Waddle, and the three of them combined for over 100 points for just those three players.
A tough one for you too, Eric. You scored almost 150 points, which is really good in this league, but you just got outscored by 20. I'm not shitting on it because normally you're like, 149, that's really good. Yeah, and then you look over at the other, you look at the other guy and it's, 170.
Yeah.
You have Cooper Kupp and Tyreek Hill in your lineup, and there's
more,
75 points right there.
I didn't even realize you had both. Holy shit. It's even more
gross in my other league. I got 175 points and I lost literally 202 to 175. That's brutal.
That's the worst
part about it is I had G. Wilson on my bench with 30 points. So I would have won the week if I'd put Wilson in.
In your guys' opinion, what's a worse loss? Getting absolutely blown out or scoring the second highest points in the league and losing to the guy who scored
I would say that's way worse because having a low scoring week is strictly the players on the field.
Sure.
Like, has nothing to do with you. Like, if you have Jefferson this week, you're sick about it.
Do you hate watching your team just be dog shit and score the lowest amount of points?
No, especially when it's top dogs.
Music superstar Eric Van Houten last week?
Who did?
Eric.
Your brother?
Yeah.
Eric beat Eric.
Eric beat Eric.
Yeah, I got beat last week. That's for sure.
Well, let me give you guys my my reason for losing. Like I told you, I had to start Alan Lazard and then Kyle Phillips. Okay. And I had 93 points, and I was against Lamar Jackson, who had 45 points. So Lamar Jackson had almost half of my points. Mm-hmm. I lost by nearly 60 points, guys. So, like, to me, I didn't even care. I was just like, yep.
Whatever. That was my question is, yeah. Do you like watching your team not do well?
No.
And losing, or scoring a lot and still losing?
Bro.
I agree with you guys on that. I think it's worse when you play the highest scoring team in the league and you have the second highest scoring team in the league for that week.
I just want to put it here, bro. I lost by 60, and he started okay. Albert Okwuegbunam, who had 0 points.
Yeah,
and I still lost by 60.
You have a guy in there that with minus 0.5. So that's not great.
I had no other options. Look at my bench. There's no receiver.
Listen, I'm not saying your bench is great.
There you go. There's Aaron Rodgers with a measly 16 points, and there's fucking Carson Wentz on my bench pushing 30.
Yeah,
that's why he's in the starting lineup unless Jay wants.
But you got to look at a lot of this stuff fantasy wise. You have to look at game flow and how games are going to play out. You look at a game like Washington versus Detroit. You know that both defenses aren't that great. So even though Detroit went up, it's all Carson Wentz from there, right? So like you have to expect that out of him. So you kind of got to look at the matchups. You know, it's very – fantasy is obviously a complete luck of the draw with players, whatever.
Oh, you're absolutely right.
You could have
that.
A Jonathan Taylor who could have the worst season, unfortunately, this year of his career.
And Derrick Henry, too.
Well, I mean,
and Derrick Henry as well.
The top, five running backs in fantasy football have all been dog shit.
Not living up to top five status, that's for sure.
So
that's why you take Wilson from the San Francisco 49ers.
Are we down, seriously? Like, I have Christian McCaffrey. I'm not down on him at all right now.
I'm not down on Eckler either, but has he...
They're all underperforming for their drafts.
Exactly.
It goes right back to my first statement about the
it is also week two, so we have a lot of football left.
Yeah.
I mean, Christian McCaffrey's averaging 16 points a week so far. Like, to me, that's okay. Like, I don't want to go lower than that. But, like, and that's 16 points a week because he hasn't had a big week yet. Is Christian McCaffrey never going to have a bad week or never have an insane week? Of course he's going to have an insane week.
If the lowest week that he gets is 15 points, you don't hate that.
Right. Like, I'm fine with Christian McCaffrey. Like, would I would have rather had Saquon Barkley there? I don't know. I still would rather have Christian there.
I think you still take the chance on Christian.
Yeah.
But I took the chance on Eckler over Justin Jefferson.
It's matchup based, man. It's always who they're playing. You just got to pay attention to who they're playing.
But to the point of these main running backs, you're never going to sit Christian McCaffrey. You're never going to sit.
Christian McCaffrey has one of the greatest quarterbacks at the helm of all time. Baker Mayfield.
He better start throwing the ball to Christian a little more. But I'm not. I don't think Christian's been a bust. Derrick Henry's kind of been a bust. I mean, Jonathan Taylor not really had a huge week and then a crappy week. So that kind of evens out. But, I mean, I think Eckler's kind of been a bust. But he made up for it at the end of the game.
He had a lot of catches that helped him at least get to his projection, yes. Which was
really nice. Is Baker
really
Mayfield
nice.
On the waiver right now?
No, he's on a
no,
team.
No, somebody
got
has him.
I think he's on my brother's team.
I will trade for him.
He's
right
on
now,
the
I swear
man.
To God.
Do it, my brother.
Let's see what you got. See if you can get a deal done.
What's your brother's team name?
Hitman.
He's the Hitman in third place.
My brother at the end of the draft had four quarterbacks because the computer drafted him two more.
Give me Baker Mayfield.
Hit him up, man.
He does have Baker and Danny Dimes.
Yeah, I'm gonna throw together an absolute asinine trade right now.
Oh, I want
to
hear
your brother picks it up.
He likes Baker though. He might not want to trade.
Well, so do I.
But he's got. I mean, he might want to start him if he's got Joey Burrow.
Here we go. You know what, guys? We're gonna we're about a half hour in right now. Let's take a break right now to hit our sponsors, and we'll be right back after this. And we're back, and we are gonna go to the new and favorite segment.
Welcome back to Let's Shit on the Bengals.
No, we're gonna get into our new and favorite segment called Get Dunked On, Bro.
Trade posted.
And I'm gonna start the Get Dunked On, Bro.
Eric Kling, what is the trade that you just sent out?
Completely asinine, but I'm here for it.
It's what we're here for. We're live on the pod.
I just offered the Hitmen, honestly, a trade that I don't know if anybody would refuse. if he doesn't accept this, I'd be absolutely rattled. Njoku, Hillard, Dak Prescott, and the Chargers defense for Baker Mayfield and I don't even know how to pronounce the last name. Etienne Jr.?
Oh, Etienne.
I mean, he's not going to accept that.
Etienne?
He's not going to accept that because of the Etienne vibes, but it's worth a shot. Maybe he'll counter.
Who knows? My brother, you know, he's been a little out of it. He could be a little rusty.
Hopefully he's smoking the joint right now. And just says
guaranteed.
It.
Yeah. There's no...
Well, let's hope that gives him a little edge here.
All right.
Just text him and tell him I made the... I offered him a trade. Make him look at it while we're on this podcast.
Chaz, let's get dunked on.
All right, get a swing!
Get dunked on, bro.
Dunked on. Adam, who do you think I'm going to be dunking on this week?
Oh, it's got to be Joe Burrow.
The same team you've been dunking on for six straight episodes?
Jay's right. I'm going to dunk on the Cincinnati Bengals because you guys are choking. You're choking. You're on the Super Bowl hangover. You're way too conservative. You're getting shut down. You lost to the Steelers and Mitch Trubisky because you were too conservative. And to be frank, I didn't watch the game against Dallas, but you couldn't beat Cooper Rush in Dallas.
Cooper Rush is a superstar.
Because you're the defending AFC champions, and you can't beat a backup quarterback. You can't beat the reeling Dallas Cowboys. You can't beat Mitch fucking Trubisky. No offense, Jay.
Sucks so far.
Right. You and your conservative play can't beat the fucking conservative play of Mitch Trubisky. Are you kidding me, Cincinnati Bengals? Y'all need a new head coach. Thank you for being so shitty and making the AFC easier for the Buffalo Bills. Cincinnati Bengals, get dunked on, bro. What you got, Adam?
Well, I have to dunk on my boy, my fantasy crush, Josh Jacobs.
Ooh, yeah.
Make the most of your opportunities because you have Davante Adams out there, and you're not going to get very many because that's where the ball's going. At least it should. And I need you to do better because you're on 90% of my teams, and that's what I have to say about that. Just be better with your opportunities.
Dunk on him, bro. Come on.
Get dunked on, bro.
Okay, thank you. Jay, what you got?
I got two.
All right, let's hear it.
The entire Indianapolis Colts offense. Get dunked on, bro. Also, honorary Trey Lance. Get dunked on, bro.
Oh, my God. Would you stop? Thank you for not dunking on me.
Well, dunking on you, too, because, you know, you got a hard on for Trey Lance, and he's dead. And I'm sorry for anyone that listens to this podcast, but I single-handedly killed him.
Yeah, Jay said at the last podcast, Eric, I hope Trey Lance breaks his leg.
He literally said that word for word. And he actually willed it into existence.
And country music superstar Eric Van Houten is here for that because fuck Trey Lance.
I do agree on that statement.
Do you got a dunk on?
I do.
Let's hear it.
Mine's going to go back to respectfully Thursday night football.
So long ago, KC
versus LA Chargers, and I'm pretty sure Herbert played with a broken rib.
A couple,
and still scored two tutties throwing the football with a broken rib, and almost won the game against the Kansas City Chiefs. So my first dunk would be on the Chiefs defense.
Ooh.
Get dunked on
by
a broken rib quarterback.
Okay,
and I think my next one, this might be a hot take, but Baltimore Ravens get absolutely dunked on for losing the game to Tua with six touchdowns.
That's fair.
And you had a guy that had 50 fantasy points in Lamar Jackson. And who else?
Are you talking about Miami Ravens or Miami?
Lamar Jackson had 50 points as a quarterback.
Yeah.
Had an incredible game. They were up winning the game
35 to 3.
So if I'm the Ravens, I want LeBron absolutely slamming his dick in their face. Get dunked on, Baltimore Ravens.
Awesome.
I was a little worried that he was going to say get dunked on Justin Herbert, and I would have been very upset.
Yeah, Jay would have flipped the table.
No. I'm a football guy, man. Herbert had a broken rib. Facts.
I would have walked out of this podcast.
Have we gotten any injury report on Herbert? Do we know what it was?
Torn cartilage around his ribs, broken cartilage, which means he broke his ribs.
The dude could barely lift his right arm, and he threw three touchdowns
because you can't break a rib.
Well, the crazy thing about Herbert in that game is like he was like hurting, and then he did that play where he scrambled and looked like he threw with his left hand, like and hit the ground, and the next play throws a fucking 45-yard dart for a touchdown. I was like, what?
That was one of the best throws I've ever seen.
Chiefs defense should get dunked on. If anything, that opens up the door for a lot of offenses to realize where the Chiefs suck, and that's on defense.
And then it's actually like multiple torn.
And the Chiefs defense got rid of freaking Matthew over the offseason. Like, get dunked on.
I believe the Chiefs defense had a score.
They had a pick six because Herbert threw that pick six. Yeah. Well,
so, was that with a broken rib, though?
Yes.
So, still, get dunked on.
Either way, but you're dunking on the Chiefs defense who scored 100%. A touchdown.
I also just hate the Chiefs.
That's fair.
Well, Adam, you just said that throw from Justin Herbert was one of the best
I've ever seen. With a broken rib and everything, and he threw an absolute laser beam.
I agree. Josh Allen, 4 days.
We know Josh Allen can do that.
No, for 4 days, because that touchdown, the second touchdown Josh threw to Diggs, when he just launched it.
Flat-footed, by the way.
55 yards.
It was absolutely
incredible.
The greatest. I even said it in our group chat. That is like the best pass I've ever seen.
The craziest part about that is that he was literally running the opposite way, flat-footed, turned his whole body, no power behind it, and just slung it.
Absolute dart.
It's an unassuming pass, but just like knowing the mechanics and how he just like, I mean, on a dime, like it was ridiculous of a pass.
And he's a freak.
Allen's an absolute freak. We can all agree. No bias to the fact. Everybody is talking about it on every talk show. The dude is a machine.
Right. And he's still the favorite for the MVP right now.
You're absolutely right.
Fantastic.
I'm going to segue into our victory lap segment.
Or a victory lap.
Because talking about...
I'm not a part of that. I've lost two games, so...
It could be anything.
Yeah, if you can think of...
Talking about a victory lap, I'm going to keep it going until they lose. Kansas City Chiefs are still daddy in the division.
This was my saying, and you act like you thought of it.
I don't care how bad...
Adam's as bad with the Chiefs as you are with the Bengals.
I don't care. Well, you guys didn't pick them to win the division like I did. I don't care how bad their defense is. They get it done, and they scored. So, my victory lap still goes out to the Kansas City Chiefs for what we thought was a powerhouse division when the Broncos proved us wrong there. And with Vegas.
And the Raiders right now.
Are not that great either.
Who are the Raiders?
Right. So, Chiefs are still daddy, winning the division.
All right, here's my victory lap because... First, the kind of minor one, when Adam and I did our daily dose for our daily fantasy football last week, if y'all didn't catch it, it'll be on YouTube. God. Adam, do you remember the cheap quarterback I plugged into my lineup because I thought he was going to have a big game?
I believe it was Jared Goff.
Jared Goff, and 4 touchdowns later and a ton of points. I won no money because I had no Dolphins in my lineup.
Do you remember my saying about the Eagles defense and how bad they were to DeAndre Swift?
Yes.
And absolutely destroyed Dalvin Cook?
Yes.
Get dunked on.
Yep.
So your victory lap is Goff.
Well, that was the minor victory. But my big victory lap to go off of what because I said this at the beginning of the year, I picked the NFC Championship game to be the Tampa Bay Buccaneers and the Philadelphia Eagles. And these two motherfuckers were like, the Eagles! Nice. They're terrible! They're not going to be good! Caw, caw, caw! The Cowboys are going to win the division! Caw, 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 caw!
That was before Dak Prescott got hurt.
Yeah, but they have Cooper Rush, dude. Let's be honest.
Bro, the Eagles look legit. Like
they look really good.
I'm surprised that Chaz's victory lap wasn't himself for saying that the Bengals were going to suck.
Yeah, that's fine.
We're only 2 weeks in. My thing with the Bengals...
When they go 0-5, we'll be right there.
The Bengals are on a fence right now. If we can just set... Not get away from the victory lap for Jay here, but maybe just talk about the Bengals for a sec. Of course, do I not want them to lose to the Bills or whatever? Yes, of course. But at the end of the day... They're on the fence. They're a 50-50 team right now, and the reason being is because they spent so much money on that offensive line for Burrow. Sometimes, like you were saying, with the only 3 preseason games, you got to give them a second to breathe.
True.
They might need a couple weeks. So literally the next 3 or 4 weeks, we're going to find out if the Bengals are true dog shit or if they are still a Super Bowl caliber
offensive line is still playing the way they did, they're in trouble.
Yeah. At the end of the day, you got Big Joe. Well, you got Big Joe, and if they can lock in that offensive line and keep him safe and let him make some plays and not give him 2.5 seconds every time, he can. They'll turn it around.
Here's my thing with the Bengals, though. So they're 0-2 right now.
Yep.
With losses to Dallas and Pittsburgh. So they're playing the Jets this week. All right, they could probably win this one. But their next schedule,
Joe Flacco might buzz on them.
But listen to their next three games, though. Miami, Baltimore, and New Orleans. Like, there's a chance that the Bengals could be what, 1-5?
Go 0-6.
Right?
Oh, there's a chance.
You can't sleep on the Jets, man.
You know, and then they come back to Atlanta, Cleveland, Carolina. Those are winnable games. But I mean,
you hope. They hope.
Okay, Jay, what's your victory lap? Sneak back to that. I didn't really have one,
but my victory lap, I guess, is gonna be
Trey Lance got hurt.
You asshole.
Yes. First, yes. No, but my real one is anyone that plays me is going to win a game, so you're welcome.
That's a good victory lap, I guess.
You got one, Eric?
I do. I have a very – I'm just with the hot takes today, or what I think are hot takes. I'm gonna give it to fucking Tua.
Okay.
Put up 6 fucking touchdowns and brought the team back with down 3 touchdowns in the 4th fucking quarter against a very good Ravens team, and I'm a Bills fan.
And you have a piece of that in Tyreek. So
I do have a piece of it.
Now, were you touting him at all?
Of course, yeah. Who wasn't shitting on his bag in the beginning of the season? I think everybody was, which is why I will give him my victory lap for today and my special guest podcast moment. The fucker balled. On Sunday, period, end of story. He balled, and he told every analyst to suck on it. And he's 2-0 with the Miami Dolphins, and he showed that Tyreek is a machine no matter what team he's on.
I agree.
He's on, and he still had another receiver put up points.
Was Tua that good, or was Baltimore's defense that bad?
Valid. I did dunk on the Ravens defense and the Ravens in general, but the bottom line is that Tua stepped the fuck up and balled. Victory lap, kid.
I will give you that one
as well. I'm sure he got laid Sunday night. He deserved it.
I said on the podcast earlier in the year that, I mean, I'm not going to say Tua is going to be amazing, but Tua was better than people were giving him credit for. I've always said that. Like, in our rankings, I think he was like my...
Who'd they play week one?
15th.
New England.
Yeah, New England.
Okay, so dog shit. So my thing with that is they've played two...
They played one dog shit team and one really good team. Yeah. Let's put it that way.
And Tua's been pretty decent. And you know what? Like you're saying, Waddle looks incredible too.
But that's opening up Tyreek. Yes. Same way that Kelsey did.
Which is what I said at the beginning of this podcast. Waddle's looking fantastic.
And like I'm going to dunk on myself right now. By the way, here's another good dunk down for me, because everything I said about Tua and the Dolphins has been true, except I was misled in my mind, because I thought I was going to have big time money in Chase Edmonds in every league, because I thought he was going to get these dump off passes.
He still will,
and I still think he will. But my thought process is true. These dump off passes are happening, but they're not Tyreek.
Yeah, they're dump offs 50 yards downfield to Tyreek Hill.
I mean, no, sometimes they're going 4 yards.
They're little tiny passes, and Tyreek's doing his thing.
I'm not out on Chase Edmonds yet. I have him in every league, but he's on my bench in every league now. But
that
I'm
was
still
my biggest fear about the Miami Dolphins was Tua throwing short to Tyreek Hill and just running past everybody.
Mahomes did the same thing. The thing that's going to open up Chase Edmonds in my mind and in any football mind is the fact that Waddle and Tyreek have been going off the last 2 weeks. So it's only going to open up the run game.
If the two of them keep cooking,
and I'm very intrigued. This is going to be, in my opinion, this is a huge matchup. He rejected it. You bastard. Didn't even counter, dude. What the hell, bro?
He's too high right now, bro.
He's very high right now.
My thing with this week, this is a Bills matchup that beginning of the season, people are looking at this game as a W. And I think it's definitely reverted back to like, okay, this might be the first challenge the Bills have this season. And my reason with that is strictly because of Tyreek Hill. He destroyed us in the last 2 years in the postseason.
It's true.
And I think it's the Bills. This is their opportunity to put Von Miller to use, put those big dogs in the front line to use, get to Tua, shut him down before he makes those quick passes, and see what happens.
I think they need Ed Oliver to get healthy in this game, because you need that pressure up the middle.
Do they?
Yeah.
They just shut down Derrick Henry without him.
Jesus Christ, here we go.
It's not about running. I'm talking about pressure up the middle. You need Oliver's pressure up the middle, because that will send Tua in a frenzy, because that would make Tua have to, like, you know, scramble out one way or the other. Remember, he's a lefty. So he's going to scramble out right into the waiting arms of Von Miller if that's the case.
Which is what you need. Yeah. Which is why we spent money and picked Von Miller up.
Yeah.
Sorry, you go ahead.
Have the Bills made a bigger statement than they have these last 2 weeks?
Oh, my God. Like, everyone is a little nervous about Miami. They're looking good.
But still,
I'm not fucking nervous. Let's go.
We're the first team in how many years that have beat two teams that have won what they said over 12 games the previous season?
Well, that was the number one team in the league last year and the number one team in the AFC going to the playoffs last year. And we literally murdered both of them.
Yeah. For the first time in like 20 years or something, this has happened.
It's insane. It happened.
So, I mean,
so I'm not afraid of Mike McDaniel and the Dolphins right now. Like, I'm concerned. You obviously got to get ready.
Yeah.
But I'm not afraid. I don't think they could. You know what? They got to keep up with us. It's not like that anymore. Tua's got to keep up with Josh Allen. So let's see if he can.
Yeah. I mean, my biggest takeaway from week one, the Thursday night Rams-Bills game, was the fact that we whopped them by 21 points and had four turnovers.
Yeah.
We don't have turnovers. We beat the shit out of the Titans. You know what I mean? Yeah. It's like, did Josh throw a pick?
No,
Monday?
No.
He didn't, yeah. No. And we didn't fumble or anything. We had no turnovers.
No turnovers.
I don't think so, no.
Insane. Yeah. And can we also talk about the fact that our first punt in forever results in a fumble recovery for the Bills?
Yeah,
I mean,
for real.
Weren't the first two
that
drops?
Was wild.
The one
what?
Was a fumble.
One was
the first was a fumble recovery, and I think he fumbled the second one, but we didn't get it.
He offered me a trade sure. back.
Oh, what you got?
See here it. We go.
All right.
What you got? He's smiling.
He just offered me Kenyon Drake and Baker Mayfield for the Los Angeles defense and Logan Thomas.
Whoa. You're getting your Baker.
You're getting your Baker Mayfield.
Jay doesn't want you to make the trade.
I don't care.
I'm going to sleep on this one. Well, I'm not going to sleep on it. I'm going to sit on it for another 20 minutes.
He's thinking it. He's pondering.
He is.
Right. I don't think it's that bad.
No, it's not.
Really?
No.
You do have four tight ends on your roster.
Yeah, I really do. I have two kickers as well. Can we talk about that? I think I might be the only guy in fantasy football that has two kickers.
Well, we have a huge bench in this league, so
it is a lot
that
of players.
That is very
on the bench.
True.
I don't know. I mean, it's a fair trade. You're never going to use Kenny and Drake, but like, I mean, you're trading away a fucking defense and your backup tight end, right?
And you have to.
He wants the Rams defense.
Oh, that was confusing.
Oh, see, well, that changes everything.
Because I have the Chargers defense.
I don't think so. Look at the Rams. I have the Rams defense in a couple of leagues, Eric. Look at their schedule coming up.
I was going to say, can you pull up their schedule for me?
Yeah, they've got a couple of, like, I know Arizona.
Let's have a look here.
They got Arizona coming up.
Arizona, San Francisco, Dallas, Carolina before the bye. And then they got San Francisco, Tampa Bay, Arizona again.
So it's not the, like, greatest. Like, I'm rolling with them in the leagues. I got them, but I don't hold them up like I thought.
What defenses are sitting on the bench right now on the waiver wire? Let's take a look at that. Let's have this chat.
People are learning how to, like, think with fantasy football here. This is nice if they don't know how
you're
to
looking
think
at
of these things.
Your beloved Carolina Panthers.
I mean, I am going to ride with Baker Mayfield. I'm sorry. I have to. Not only is he a dog and is he a dude and is he a buddy that I've had a lot of cocktails with. I will say, I think he might show up. Give him a minute.
As in, like, the rest of the season be like a starting fantasy football quarterback?
KC's defense is sitting on the waiver wire.
Well, you just said how much shitty they were.
You did dunk on them.
You literally just dunked on them.
I did dunk on them.
Yeah, I dunked on them too and dropped them.
Here's my thing with fantasy football and defenses. It's all matchup-based
totally
for me.
Totally matchup.
It's all matchup-based. Yep. So unless I have a Bills defense or, like, a stout defense, I'm always viable to just pick up and drop per week because that's just how I roll.
Same.
I've been doing it.
I mean, you got a team.
Actually, I don't think I have. I got the Steelers.
You know,
in
you
league.
Got Raiders defense is still out there, which is trash, sure. But they're, you know, they're up against trash. The Titans who don't have much.
Fuck you, Jay.
What about Seattle's defense against Atlanta?
Seattle against Atlanta? You got Houston against Chicago?
Or better yet, what about Atlanta's defense against Seattle? Yeah.
You know, Geno Smith's going to fall apart at some point.
Oh, absolutely.
Yeah.
I mean, he already did.
Jay, what do you think about that trade?
What trade?
Carson Wentz for Tom Brady.
Ooh.
I'll have to sleep on it.
The number three quarterback in fantasy.
I think you need to make a decision.
I think you should make a decision before
right now,
the podcast
on the
ends.
Podcast.
You know, we're not done yet. You don't have to do it yet because I'm going to pose a new question for a couple of you guys here. We're going to roll through two questions. We'll start with Adam here. Adam.
Chaz.
New draft today. You have the first overall pick. Who is it?
New draft today?
Yep. You have the first overall pick. Two games in. Who are you taking?
Man, that is a tough question, but honestly, Stephon Diggs.
First overall?
Or Josh Allen, one of the two.
I wouldn't be opposed to Josh Allen.
I'd probably go Josh. First overall pick, you're saying, right?
Yeah.
I'm probably going Josh Allen.
Because if you think about it, I wouldn't be opposed to it. There's like three good starting quarterbacks in the league right now. And, you know, 25 running backs, 40 receivers. Sure. Like, the quarterback position has fell off a fucking cliff this year.
Yeah, it really did. You have Josh Allen, Hurts, we talked about earlier.
Mahomes.
Herbert. Who didn't have a great week last week, but... And Herbert's up there still. Lamar Jackson is having a great season. There's your five. After that, you have...
Fucking mess.
Your Kyler Murray's, your...
Brady's,
who hasn't done anything. Your dog
Wentz.
Shit.
I mean, Wentz is the number three fantasy quarterback.
And he went undrafted. Mm-hmm. And so did Goff.
And he was your Nabra.
He was my Nabra.
So, Eric, I pose the same question to you. Who do you take first overall if there's a new draft today?
I mean, it's forever Cup.
You're sticking with Cup?
I mean, you have to. The dude just puts up numbers. It doesn't matter who he plays.
Would you do Cup in a half-point PPR league as well? Would that change things?
I would.
Yeah. The dude catches 10 or 11 every game.
Yeah, exactly.
You're still getting
exactly
6 points out of him before he even scores a tutty.
Yep.
Right? All right, Jay, what about you?
I mean, what they said is probably the real answer. It's got to be like Allen or Cup at this point. I mean, especially the way that all the like top 10 running backs have been dog shit pretty much for the most part. So, I mean, you're going to...
I might go Allen. I would said my first overall pick at the beginning of the year would have been McCaffrey. And I mean, he's still there for me. But I mean, I would put Saquon in the mix in my head. I mean, I don't know if I'd pull the trigger on Saquon over some people, but I mean, he's getting the work, man. And that team is up there. So that's where I would be in those three. But you know, Allen is just killing it. And they're so much better for Christian McCaffrey to come, and he's been the only like top running back pick that has been okay. Taylor's been okay too. He has been decent.
And Eckler, Taylor.
Well,
I mean, you can't go Taylor
you're
asking right now with the stats that the players have.
Well, it's not about stats; it's about your feeling and moving forward.
Well, do I think Jonathan Taylor is going to suck all season? No, absolutely not. Do I think Derrick Henry is going to suck all season? No, absolutely not. It's Derrick Henry and Jonathan Taylor. They're going to have better weeks. Unfortunately, actually, I'm not even going to say unfortunately. I'm going to say fortunately, there's a lot of fantasy football left, and you're lucky if you're 0-2 and you have them guys and they go off, because now you have a chance still.
Right.
You know, it's unfortunate if you start getting into the 0-4, 0-5, 0-6. Then you might not have that much of a chance to make playoffs in your leagues. But just be happy that if you do have them on your squad and you are 0-2, that... God, please don't let me eat my words on this one, is that there should be better games for them. But in this moment, Josh Allen's number one for me.
And to go back on Derrick Henry, I said I would consider Derrick Henry first overall at the beginning of the season. I mean, he hasn't looked like he used to. I don't know. I mean, I'm not saying he's done.
Because they're playing
their situation,
for the run,
man.
Because they know that they ain't got shit.
Here's my counter offer.
Okay, this is going to my brother, right?
He's trying to get Logan Thomas and the Rams defense. I'm going to send him Hillard, Logan Thomas, and the Rams defense for a hurt George Kittle and Baker Mayfield.
Oh, I don't think he does that. I mean, I know he's hurt, but he's going to come back and get hurt again.
Yeah. He ain't going to do shit.
He only has three good games in it. Yeah. I just don't know when they are.
Yeah, exactly.
And we'll see what he does.
The guy got hurt in practice and missed 2 weeks.
Right. I just don't think he's going to accept it.
I've had him on my fantasy team multiple times.
Is it worth it?
Dog shit.
He's good when he's good. He's good for the three games a year.
Listen, when he's out there, and now that Jimmy G's there again, still. Well, I shouldn't say again. I should say still. But now that he's the starting quarterback, he loves George Kittle.
Now, just imagine if he would have took.
But you just have to be on the field.
Yeah, exactly. He can't get on the field.
Imagine if he would have took somebody like Travis Kelce instead of like Javonte Williams or Breece Hall or people like that. Who did that? Oh, that was me, because. It was just too trash at that point. Okay, here's my second question, and we're going to get out of here shortly. I'll start this one with country music superstar Eric Van Houten.
All right.
Today, who is your Super Bowl pick? Who's going to be the Super Bowl as of today? What do you think? 2 weeks in, I know. I just want to see
who's going to win the Super Bowl, or what teams are going to be
in it? What is going to be the Super Bowl? That's all I'm asking.
What teams are in it?
Yeah.
I'm assuming
we're all picking the Bills, but you know, who do you think is in the Super Bowl as of today? 2 weeks in, wondering if anyone's thoughts have changed.
I'm going to go with what everyone in the entire country hopes doesn't happen.
What's that?
And that's the Eagles versus the Bills.
It's a
most aggressive fan bases. There will be a civil war between Philadelphia and Buffalo.
Okay.
The entire state of Pennsylvania and New York will be under construction if that if those teams go to the Super Bowl.
That's very well.
But I don't think if the Eagles can keep playing the way they're playing and everybody stays healthy, you have that defensive scenario that's just disgustingly good. I think I just don't think you get past them. And I think if Hurts can keep balling like he's balling, and I think they can beat the shit out of Tom Brady. I think I just did it last night in Madden, Eagles versus Buccaneers, and I smoked them. And I just think
it was super high.
I was very very high. Was probably on the rookie level, but it's still bar none. I just think the Eagles have what it takes as of week two.
Okay. And was that? I'm assuming that wasn't your Super Bowl.
No, my initial pick out of the NFC conference was either Bucks, or I didn't see the Rams doing it. There's always that hiccup, that Super Bowl hiccup. And I don't know, man. I mean, you just can't hate on Jimmy G if he's in the game. What I'm saying? Give it to Jimmy G.
How many times have you made out with Jimmy G?
He's probably wanted to make out with me a few times. I'm not going to lie to you. But I don't know, man. I mean, San Francisco just has that weird itch about him.
Those are great like ideas. And Philly, that's going to be tough for me not to pick, but it's not my turn. It's Adams. What is your pick? Your original one was what?
My original one was the Bills and the Bucks.
Bills and the Bucks.
Which would be completely ideal for Bills fans because of the Brady shit.
I know what the Bucks are going through. With Tom Brady not being Tom Brady.
But he's always Tom Brady.
But he's Tom Brady.
He's always Tom Brady.
And they're still 2-0.
You know, I didn't even realize that. Yeah.
My pick does not change. It is still the Bucks and the Bills in the Super Bowl.
It's just you can't. Again, we have done it
for 20 years betting against Tom Brady, and he's bit us in the ass a million times. I can't do it.
If you guys remember Tom Brady circa like 2012, remember he like went on this 4-game tear of being absolutely horrendous, and people were talking about benching him. I remember, Jay, in our fantasy football league that year, Lauren dropped him. And I went out and picked him up in free agency, and he won the fucking NFL MVP that year because he went insane.
Well, the thing with the dude is you can't. It's the age old fucking saying, you cannot poke the fucking bear. And a prime example happened on Sunday. Listen, they poked the fucking bear. Lattimore threw his hand in his face. They were tied 3-3 in the fourth quarter, and Tom said, "Suck on my nuts. I'm Tom Brady." And he threw three touchdown passes.
He's
and they
getting
won again.
Upset while winning.
It's true.
Not by much. Don't get me wrong. They only won 20-10. But you're right. 3-3
and he threw two tutties.
8 minutes left in the third quarter, you don't score a touchdown.
Now you're gonna make Jay not want to make the trade with me.
I'm sorry.
He's not really that great of a fantasy ball player over the last
not at the
five
moment.
Years. Over the last
no,
5 years.
Last year he was fantastic.
Last year he was great.
Last year was the second best.
He led the league in touchdowns.
He led the league in touchdown passes.
Right. And yards.
Yep, I stand corrected.
5,300 yards and 43 touchdowns. Yeah, don't get me wrong. Again. He had 12 interceptions to Aaron Rodgers' 4.
That's why Aaron Rodgers.
That's why Aaron Rodgers won the MVP.
Fuck Aaron Rodgers.
But he also cried.
All right, Jay, you're up. What you got? What was your original?
My original was Bills Bucks, and staying the same. They're 2-0 with not a fucking wide receiver that anyone knows. They're all dead, and they're still winning.
And now Mike Evans suspended for 1 week.
Cole Beasley, y'all.
Beasley, right? Yeah. Right up to the active roster.
He's gonna ball.
Cole Beasley is Tom Brady's kind of boy.
He's perfect for fucking.
Watch
Tom Brady.
Watch Beasley go off the rest of the season.
Maybe,
guaranteed.
Maybe he could be well, but I mean he's buried underneath three like really good receivers if they're healthy. So that's the only thing.
Yeah, but no Mike Evans, no Godwin,
and no Gage and no Julio right now.
Well, actually, Gage is like the only one that might play.
He's still questionable.
Yeah, I know.
And there's no way that Cole Beasley plays this week. I mean, Joe's going to the practice squad today. So, I mean,
he's an NFL football player. He's been in the league for how many years? Like, you're telling me they're not going to put him in the slot? You're out of your mind.
Woo, you gave me the spicy one. That is spicy.
Yeah.
It's good, though.
I don't like the spicy ones.
My original AFC championship game, I don't even remember. It was the Bills and the Raiders. I don't know. Maybe still going. My original NFC championship game was the Bills and the Eagles. So I was on the Eagles train early, but I picked Bills and Bucks, and I'm with these other two guys. I'm sticking with it right now. So
I think the Eagles are going to show up and show out. And at the end of the day, if the Eagles don't have to play the Bucks, it probably would favor them.
Yeah. And
if it turns out where like the Bucks play somebody else in the divisional round or whatever it is, I think they, you know, depending on who's on the wide receiver slot and what team they're up against, they might not. You know, but again, that's betting against Tom Brady. It's really
we can't forget how good the Bucs defense is too.
Very true.
So there's a big part.
On fire
the
right
Bucs
now.
Defense is legit.
Yeah,
they've been legit. I mean, that team. That the reason I pick. I mean, this is like a great team that happens to have Tom Brady. It's not just Tom Brady. This is a great. Yeah. This is a great team with Tom Brady.
I guess my only thing at this point of the season for them is the coach. You lose. You know, you lose Arians, right?
Yeah.
And
yeah,
you get,
but he's still in the beast, organization. Still. He's still in the organization. I think he's like president of football operations.
He's down fighting on the sidelines.
But
he was, he was there.
I think that Brady wants to call the shots, and that's they catered to him. So, okay. Like, I mean, guy won the Super Bowl in the first year with you, should have been an NFL MVP the second year with you, and all of a sudden Aaron he Rodgers. Fell off a mountain. Maybe he did fall off a mountain, but maybe he'll figure it out. I mean, that's for Jay to decide if he wants to trade for Carson Wentz with me or not. But I feel the pain with Brady because I have him in another league. So I'm not like clamoring for him. But so we're at the end of our
rope.
Yeah,
what's the other question? Did you have another one?
No, those are the two. Oh. But here's another question for you, country music super Eric Van Houten. What do you want to promote? What you got coming? What you got going on in life right now with your music?
Well, when does this air?
This
is going to come
Friday.
Out Friday. So
2 days from now.
Yep.
Correct.
We have a show Tuesday at Babeville. Which is the church downtown that Ani DeFranco turned into an amazing music venue.
Yeah, it's a real cool music venue.
And we're opening up for Johnny Swim. It's not necessarily a country show. They're more of like a indie rock group. We're managed by the same people, and they're unbelievable talent. It's a married couple, and they're very, very incredible. It's worth it. So come on out to that show Tuesday, and get on Spotify, Apple Music, wherever you listen to tunes, and just hit the play button. And if you don't like it, throw your phone out the window and call it a day.
Well, we're going to give you as our lead out song today. So what song would you like us to play for you?
This is the tune that's kind of been changing my life a little bit. It's called Shut Up and Kiss Her.
Shut Up and Kiss Her. Okay, so that's how we're going to end. So country music superstar Eric Van Houten, thank you for joining us.
Thanks for having me, boys.
Next time you're in town, you're always welcome on. We're going to try to do this all year, even in the off season. Maybe we'll do some more of like what All Bets Are Off podcast with Robbie Vegas does and do some different things. But you're always welcome. And I know that you come from time to time, so because this is your hometown, even though you're in the big city of Nashville now, which you were a gracious host when I was there last year.
Love
so
it.
That was fantastic. So thank you again. And then brother of country music superstar Eric Van Houten, Adam Van Houten, thank you for being out as always.
Thank you for having me again.
And Jay, thank you for coming on. Grumpy Cat over here.
I'm not Grumpy Cat.
Not yet. But if he goes 0-3, he might be.
Well, Jay, real quick, Jay, what is your league? What's your overall record in both leagues?
0-4. And it's all Adam's fault.
I didn't had nothing to do with it.
So I just wanted
to, it might be a little bit.
In my three leagues, I'm
Adam's bad luck.
I'm 6-2. Just saying, I'm pretty good right now. So all right.
Yeah. Chaz was awful quiet this week because he finally lost. Compared to last week when he was like, guys, I'm undefeated.
I was.
I'm undefeated.
Every
5 minutes,
he's like, I'm undefeated.
I was. All right. Well, thank you, everybody, for checking out the Fantasy Football Bros podcast. Enjoy the Eric Van Houten song, and we will see you next week, y'all.
Country music superstar Eric Van Houten.
Later, guys.
She's felt this kind of way. Just look at her smile, saying the things that she can't say. She's biting her lip now, your hands on her hip now. There's only one more move for you left to make. Shut up and kiss her. You're thinking too much. And turn off. So don't overthink it. and get it. She's got it written on the walls. Quit making excuses like you don't normally do this. You got nothing to lose, so what could go wrong? Yeah. Shut up and kiss her, you're thinking too much. Turn off the whisper and just feel the rush. Get lost in the moment, all it feels right on. And what you're waiting for is all in your head, yeah. Shut up and kiss her. Shut up and kiss her. Don't keep waiting. No, don't complicate it. Quit hesitating. Don't complicate it. Don't keep waiting. Lord knows she's waiting on you. Yeah. Just shut up and kiss her. You're thinking too much. And turn off the whisper and just feel the rush. Yeah. Shut up and kiss her.
The preceding presentation has been brought to you by the Gear Network.